everyone, welcome back to the channel of Ecoholics. So in today's video, we will be discussing another solution for IIT JAM Economics 2023 paper. We have been solving a lot of questions from IIT JAM 2023 paper. In today's video, we will be discussing the solution for question number 49. So this is question number 49 from NAT type question. Now, in NAT type questions, you have to be very sure because you are not provided with multiple options out of which at least one will be correct. So, be very careful with your calculations when you are attempting a NAT type question. Now, this question will expect your conceptual knowledge. It is just for testing your conceptual knowledge. It's a very easy question. Might be looking tricky when you see a lot of numbers on the paper, but this is a really simple question. So it gives you an estimated regression equation. And the important thing here is large sample. Also, it says the 95% confidence rule we have used, the confidence interval according to 95%, the limit, the lower limit and upper limit are given here. And the value of R square is also given. So you have to calculate the standard error of the estimated coefficient. Now there are two methods through which you can do this. But both of the methods will require you to use the upper limit and lower limit of the confidence intervals. So I'm choosing the easiest way here. So what I know is, like what we know from the conceptual knowledge is, that the lower limit of the confidence interval is given by beta hat plus, so this is the upper limit, plus standard error of beta hat into t statistic, the t ratio we have, which is because it's a 95% confidence interval, so alpha will be 5%, whereas alpha by 2 will be 2.5%. So 0.025 n minus 2. Why have I written n minus 2? Because the degrees of freedom here will be n minus 2. As we just have two parameters here. So whenever we work with the t-test statistic, the t-ratios, we need to find the degrees of freedom which are given by n minus k. Here k means the number of parameters which are 2 here. So this is the upper limit and it has to be equal to 6.14. Now what is beta hat? Beta hat is the estimated value of slope coefficient, which is 3.2 here. Standard error we have to find. And now how do we find the t value? It is not given here. Since it is written that it's a large sample. So when it comes to large sample, so large sample can be 30, it can be 40, it can be 50 and anything. So for the large sample values, if you will go to the t tables, you can see that 0.025, it will be approximately equal to 1.96. So I will be putting up the same value, which is equivalent to 6.14. Now solving this, standard error of beta hat into 1.96 is equivalent to 6.14 minus 3.2. And then dividing with the same standard error of beta hat, and I will divide the result here with 1.96, which will give me the answer as 1.5. Now they have clearly written that you just have to round off it to one decimal place. So be very sure if you are getting, for example, 1.56. So always write 1.5 as your answer. So the correct answer here is 1.5. So you see how easy this was, but just by having a look at the statement, you can get trapped that no, it's going to be difficult. Maybe you will skip. This is a question from econometrics or from stats. Like I have to use both of the techniques, so it will be difficult. Don't do it. It's very easy. It's just that you have to clear your concepts here. I hope this video will be useful for you. For more such solutions, please follow Ecoholics on YouTube. Also, like this video, share this video with your friends. Thank you so much.